नमस्ते, प्रणाम। गीता ध्यान। ओम पार्थाय प्रतिबोधिताम् भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथिताम् पुराण मुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीम् भगवतीम् अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम् अम्बत्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणीम्। ओ भगवत गीता, विथ विच लॉर्ड नारायणा हिमसेल्फ गेव एनलाइटनमेंट टू अर्जुना, विच वॉज इंक्लूडेड इन द महाभारत बाय द एंशंट सेज व्यास। ओ गॉडेस, शॉवरर ऑफ द नेक्टर लाइक नॉलेज ऑफ नॉन डुअलिज्म कंटेंड इन योर 18 चैप्टर्स। ओ माई अफेक्शनेट मदर, द डिस्ट्रॉयर ऑफ रीबर्थ, माई सैल्यूटेशन टू यू। नौ कृष्ण वंदना। वसुदेव सुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकीं परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं। ओ सन ऑफ वसुदेव, द स्लेयर ऑफ कंस एंड चाणूर, एक्सट्रीम डिलाइट फॉर मदर देवकी। ओ कृष्णा, द सुप्रीम टीचर ऑफ द यूनिवर्स, माई सैल्यूटेशंस टू यू। And today we take up the fifth shloka of the Karma Yoga, the third chapter of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. And Shri Krishna is slowly, getting rid of Arjuna's doubts, Arjuna's confusion. Arjuna has said, tell me, once you tell me that karma is great, another time you tell me jnana, knowledge is great. Now, which of these two is the real great thing, O Krishna? I am confused now. Please explain it to me. And then Krishna tells him, oh my dear Arjuna, he addresses him as Anagha, O sinless one, what I have told you is not contradictory. There is no need to get confused from what I told you in the Sankhya Yoga. In fact, both this karma and the jnana paths, these two paths, this twofold path, I have already given it to mankind long back. It is not to be, one should not be get confused of either of these two paths, which is great. Because it is not that one is great and one is superior, one is inferior. No, they are both complementary. And then Sri Krishna is now explaining on, while in the Sankhya Yoga, Sri Krishna has explained all the greatness of the path of knowledge. Now he tells that path of karma is also equally important. It is not that you can just give up karma and start proceeding only on the path of knowledge. He says that stage of naishkarmya, the one becoming actionless, it comes much later on. And therefore, whatever work has come to one's lot, one must perform it in a detached manner, dedicatedly, steadfastly, but with no focus on the outcome of the work, the result of the work, the fruit of the work. That we don't have any right on. We don't have any right on the fruit of the work. What is our right? Our right is only to work, work, work. And in this particular connection, actually, I remember our Holy Mother Ma Sarada Devi's words also, that that this thing, the total detachment from work, comes much later. Through work alone can one remove the bondage of karma, not by avoiding the work, not by abstaining from the work. That total detachment of getting into the state of actionlessness comes much later, when the knowledge dawns upon the person as a result of that action, the motiveless karma. That knowledge dawns at the end, and when that knowledge dawns, there is no need to perform any karma at all. it automatically drops off. Like Sri Ramakrishna had told us in that example, that when a girl gets married, comes to the in-laws' household, to the husband's house, she is flooded with work by her mother-in-law, by her sister-in-law, and everybody in the family, do this, do that. But when that girl, that daughter-in-law, she becomes pregnant and is about to deliver the child, as she becomes pregnant, slowly the amount of work comes down. And as the newborn baby comes there in the family, that lady, that girl, she doesn't have to perform any duties. She has to just take care of the child. That is the only duty. And likewise, Sri Ramakrishna has said, once you gain that ultimate knowledge, then all this work, duty, and those aspects of action, they drop off. There is no need. You have to only focus on me and my mother. Well, now what Shri Krishna further tells Arjuna on this particular subject. Nahi kaschit kshanam api jatu tishthati akarmakrut karyate yavashah karma sarvah prakrutir prakriti jair gunaihi nahi kaschit kshanam api not nahi is not kaschit anyone kshanam moment api even for a moment, even for a single moment, nobody jatu verily tishthati remains akarmakrut. Not a single moment anyone, any person remains actionless. That cannot happen, Sri Krishna says. Although one may say that I want to get rid of all the work and I just want to leave and go to Himalaya, sit in the cave and gain knowledge. No, that doesn't happen. Because Sri Krishna says, even for a moment, not a single person can remain actionless, can remain without work, akarmakrut. It is just not possible. Why? Karyate yavashah karma. Karyate is made, that person is made. He for verily that person is made avashah, helpless, karma, action. For that person is helpless, that person is forced to perform that work, perform the action, perform that duty. Sarva, all, prakriti jaihi, gunaihi, for the qualities, three gunas born of prakriti will make him work, work and work. He cannot remain workless, without work, even for a moment. And that is Sri Krishna's teaching to Arjuna. And don't think that people can just avoid work. By saying, I am abstaining this work, they can become actionless. No. None can ever remain really actionless, even for a moment. For everyone is helplessly driven to action. Even if they don't want to, they are helplessly driven to action by the gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas, born of prakriti. These three gunas, which is actually maintaining the cycle of this nature, of the prakriti, is forcing us. It's forcing us to keep on doing some work. All these three gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas, they are all actually enforcing the work upon all of us, on everyone. The prakriti or nature is constituted of the three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas. It is ever in a state of flux. It is always constantly moving on and on because of the three gunas. And in other words, karma is inherent in prakriti. It is an inherent property of the prakriti. Because if prakriti is not there, prakriti is nothing but manifestation of Brahman in that particular active form. And the karma becomes, the work, action, it becomes inherent quality of the prakriti. It is inherent nature of the prakriti. Beings evolved in prakriti are therefore helplessly bound by karma. And we are all the products, we are all the progeny, we are all the children of this prakriti. The Mahamaya aspect of the prakriti, the great cosmic delusion of the prakriti, that we are born. And as we are born, as the manifestation of this prakriti, we are bound to be in the action, because the creation, preservation, destruction, these three aspects of the action are constantly there in the prakriti. And accordingly, we have to also go by that cycle of action. Vain is their wish and attempt to rid themselves of action. You cannot. Although we decide to not to do any work as such, still our body is doing some work. Eating, sleeping, breathing, beating of the heart also is karma. We are breathing is also karma. We are performing that action. We cannot avoid it. We cannot avoid it till the moment this breath goes in, comes out. It is only when it comes out and doesn't get in, then for that body, the karma part is over. Till then, the body has to perform karma. All these are nothing but karma. From the atop of the universe, all are engaged in activities of innumerable types. It is not only doing your office work, doing project work, which is regarded as karma. That is not the only work. Any kind of work, any kind of action, any kind of activity is the work in which we are always engaged, we are always involved. It is impossible for beings to renounce karma while being entangled in prakriti. It is just impossible, and Sri Krishna tells there is no alternative. And then, if there is no alternative, then why not enjoy doing this work as the work allotted to me by the Lord, the work allotted to me by my mother. Let us do it. Let us do it without any motive. Let us do it without any expectation for the fruit. Just doing it as the Lord's work. Now on this particular shloka, that everybody, whether they like it or not, we have to get involved in this work. We have to do the work. We cannot escape, we cannot avoid, we cannot run away. And what Sri Ramakrishna has said on this particular thing, Sri Ramakrishna says, those who are enlisted as indoor patients in a hospital cannot get out of it until they are cured. Now, once a patient is sick and needs hospitalization, that patient is taken to the hospital. Now, until the time the treatment is complete and he gets cured, he cannot leave the hospital. He cannot run away from that bed that is allotted to him. He has to be there. He has to get those medicine whether he likes it or not. He has to undergo all those procedures whether he likes it or not. But he has to coolly, calmly, patiently, steadily accept that fact that I am admitted to the hospital to get better, to get cured. So, whatever is happening here, they are giving me 50 tablets a day. They are poking all those syringes and needles in my body, giving saline, giving drips, doing that. The patient has to bear everything calmly. After the cure is effected, they have no need to be there in the hospital. Now, after you are okay, after you recover, then who will allow you to remain on that bed? Now, as it is, the hospitals nowadays, they want the beds vacant for the next incoming patient. Similarly, beings that suffer from the ailment of ignorance are hospitalized in prakriti. Now, till the time we are deluded by this Mahamaya and we have this the covering of ignorance on our self, till the time that ignorance is there, we have to go by whatever Prakriti tells us. We have to abide by the injunctions of the Prakriti. Work, 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 work. No running away from that. They are being effectively treated with karma for enlightenment. And Sri Ramakrishna says this, working on the part of human beings, on the part of beings for that matter. Why only human beings? Is working on the part of beings who are very much the part and parcel of the Prakriti. It is that work itself is leading them towards enlightenment. It is not that any work that is being done is going waste. No. Whatever work is being done, we are all progressing towards that enlightenment, getting that knowledge, getting the ultimate knowledge of our oneness with the ultimate reality. With the dawn of Brahma Jnanam, they quit Prakriti and then they get into the state of actionlessness. Not before that. While working selflessly without any attachment, when the knowledge dawns upon us that Aham Brahmosmi, that Brahmajnana, that oneness with the Brahman, when that knowledge illumines within ourself, then that is the end of our attachment with the Prakriti. That is the end of being subservient to the Prakriti, to the laws of Prakriti. And then we just cross over the boundary, and from that action-oriented part, we get into the state of actionlessness after that knowledge dawns, after we get that illumination, not before that. So till then, we have to, like Sri Krishna said in this, till then, everybody, whether they like it or not, they are forced into this action. No running away, no escaping, no getting rid of action, work, duty. So that's how it is. So we are helpless for that matter, because we are into this gamut of Prakriti, into this gamut of action. We have to perform it. So that is the fifth shloka of the Karma Yoga of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Sri Krishna Arpanamastu. Jai Sri Ramakrishna. Jai Thakur. Jai Ma. Jai Swamiji.